Give me Matthew chapter 18, verse 19, sister. This is the scripture we all know.
Yes, sister. Agreement prayer, sister. Again, I say unto you that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done for them by my Father which is in heaven.
Praise God. Again, I say unto you that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done for them of my Father which is in heaven. Now, this is what Jesus is saying.
Yes.
Okay, in the next verse he says, for wherever two or three come together in my name, I am there in the midst of.
Yeah.
Praise God. You know, I love this scripture so much, sister. Okay, of what I understood, what the Lord revealed to me, okay?
Yeah.
Praise God.
Praise God.
In the beginning, sister, when I was reading the scripture, he says that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done for them by my Father which is in heaven.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, sister, in those days when I started my journey, I did not know many people whom I can contact and get them to do the agreement prayer. I did not even know at that time that this is called as the agreement prayer.
Yeah.
Okay. So my question to the Holy Spirit used to be, Lord, I don't have anyone. How will I agree with? I need one person to agree with me.
Yes. Holy Spirit is a person, no, sister.
Ah, correct. Holy Spirit is the person who is here on earth.
Yeah. If you agree with him, it is two people agreeing.
Yes. So the Holy Spirit began to teach me. He said, if you are willing to agree with what the Word of God says, okay,
yeah,
and according to the scriptures, if two of you are agreeing on earth as touching anything for something that you are praying, Jesus says it will be done by my Heavenly Father.
Yeah.
Okay. So, praise God. One day it so happened. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. One day it so happened, sister. There was one person who was sick, okay, at my office.
Okay.
And this person, we were just having a meeting, okay, we were talking, and suddenly this person pushed himself back on the seat, you know, on the chair.
Mm.
Okay. And when he pushed himself back on the chair, he began to experience pain in his spine, in his back. Okay. And suddenly he said, oh, you know, this pain is really making me feel so miserable. It's so painful. Okay. So I told him, I said, listen, do you believe that Jesus can heal you? Okay. So this person was not a Christian. Okay. So this person said, yeah, of course, I believe Jesus can heal me. Okay. And then I brought his, you know, I began to tell him that, you know, according to the Word of God, he says what he has promised is that the wounds that he suffered on his body when he was being crucified, okay, those wounds were because of our sin. Okay. And he has taken your sin also upon his body, and in exchange he has given you this healing. He has healed you.
Okay.
Are you following?
Yeah.
Okay. So this time I said, Lord, I'm going to help him understand the truth, and the rest is your work.
Yeah.
Okay. So I said, okay, if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done for them by my Father in heaven. That's what Jesus is saying.
Yes.
Okay, now, who is Jesus? The Savior?
Yes.
Is Jesus also the healer?
Yes.
Now, is the Savior and the healer both present on the inside of me?
Yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
Okay, now, when I am agreeing with the Savior that he has saved this person from his sin by extending the free gift of grace, okay, and I am agreeing with the healer, Jesus, who says, I have taken his sin upon my body and suffered the sickness, the back pain that he's going through, and in exchange I've given him the healing, I have already healed him. Now, are we, am I, sister, now in agreement with Jesus, the Savior and the healer?
Yes.
Are you following now?
Yeah.
That if two of you shall agree on earth, now Jesus and I, the Word, we are in agreement. The Holy Spirit is in agreement.
Yes.
Okay. Now, when I am in agreement, okay, I am saying now, sister, this person did not even understand the meaning of the word amen.
Okay.
Okay. He's not a Christian. Okay. So I told him, I said, listen, the word of God says when two of us agree for something on this earth, as you know, when we believe and we agree upon it, the word of God says it will be done by the Father in heaven. Okay. So I began to speak to him and I said, come on, let's believe the word and let's see the glory of God manifest. Okay. Yeah. So we made a prayer. And we said, Lord, thank you. This healing is manifested. It is done by the Father, which is in heaven. Okay. Now, as soon as we finished, as soon as I said, amen, do you know what happened?
That pain left.
No, the pain was still there.
Okay.
Okay. The pain was still there. Now, when the pain was there, okay. Now, the immediate question will come, hey, it's not healed. What will this person think now? And plus, he's not a Christian. Are you understanding?
Yeah.
So all your claims have gone for a waste. Your God does not keep his word. All that thought will come.
Yes.
When the thought was coming and that person's, and I asked him, can you just check, stretch and see what, try to do what you were not able to do, and he was not able to do it. He was not able to stretch because of the pain. Okay. Mm-hmm. Now my eyes are telling me, sister, that the pain is there and he's not able to do move. Okay. But the word of God, the unseen word of God, is telling me that he is healed. Which one are we going to believe?
The word of God.
The word of God. And I told him, listen, the word says that you are healed.
Yeah.
Okay. Now you make a choice whether you're going to believe that you're healed or whether you're going to look at the symptom. Okay. So he said, no, no. Okay. I believe I'm healed. Next day I asked him, how are you? Pain is gone? No, no. It is still there. Okay. And I said, praise God, you are healed. Because the word of God says when two or three agree for something, when two of you agree for something on this earth, believing in him, it's the word of God says it shall be done for them by my Father in heaven. Shall be done. It does not say he will do it. It shall be done. That means the moment we finish that prayer, the answer has already come.
Yes.
Okay. But for that answer, for that healing to manifest, remember, we are in a battle.
Yeah.
There is an accuser who is blocking that manifestation to show forth in my life so that he can keep me in unbelief.
Yes.
Who is he? He's the adversary.
Yeah, the devourer.
Okay. So, after a week, I asked him, how are you? Pain is still there. Okay. And After that, I stopped asking him. Okay, you know how I stopped asking him? When continuously for 1 week, when I kept asking, how are you? How are you? How are you? He kept saying the pain is there. The pain is there. Okay. So in that 1 week, the Lord began to ask me, are you asking him, how are you, believing that he is healed? Or are you asking him, how are you, to get a confirmation from him that he is healed? Are you understanding, sister?
Yes, yes, yes. That sister, means you are asking him to get a confirmation. Whereas yes.
Correct. I was asking, I kept on asking every day, how are you? How are you? Because I wanted him to say that he is healed. I wanted to hear. So is my focus again on the scene?
Yes.
So from that day onwards, I stopped asking. Okay. After a month and a half or so, okay, our team had gone for a trip. Okay, sister? And we had gone for a trek. And this person is, he does not go on treks because of the back pain that he has.
Okay.
Okay. And this time he said, no, I'm going to come. I'm going to come on the trek. Okay. It was about a 2 to 3 kilometers trek we had. And it was really, steep. So everyone was walking and I was also walking along. And this person was right behind. Okay. Hmm. And he continued to walk and everyone was like, don't stress. Okay. He said, no, I'm fine. And I had reached the point. Okay. Hmm. And we were all over there. And this person was the last person to reach to that top.
Yeah.
Okay. And when he reached to the top, he comes to me and he says, you know, the pain is not there at all.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Because I experienced no pain, I was thinking it will pain. And when it starts paining, I will stop. But the pain did not even come. It's gone.
Praise God.
Are you understanding now?
Yes.
See, when the word of God is spoken, you've got to believe that word and keep your ground strong. You've got to stand on solid ground that what is spoken, it is done. Whether I see the manifestation or I don't see the manifestation, I believe it is done. Why? Because God is faithful to his word.
Yes.
Are you understanding? Let's take some questions.
The first question is, how is a prayer different from an agreement prayer?
Okay, a prayer is nothing but speaking to God his word.
Yeah.
Okay, where you are fellowshipping with the Lord, you're speaking to him his word, you're praising him, you're declaring his good works, that is called as prayer.
Praise.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, praise, prayer. So agreement prayer is where, like what we just learned in the scripture, okay, where you come into agreement with what the written word of God is saying. Now you come into agreement with a person who is believing the same word as you are believing. You are agreeing to what the written word of God is saying. And now when you're agreeing to what the written word of God is saying, Jesus says, it will be done by my Father in heaven. Why? Because the promises of God in Christ Jesus is always a yes and an amen.